Gi-un turns to frontman or VIP, I'm not agree with this theory. I almost don't agree every theory, I think. Hi guys, this is Ho-yeon. I played 강세벽 in Squid Game, and we are going to talk about fan theories for Squid Game at Vanity Fair. Spoilers ahead, so watch out.
이 자리에 오신 여러분을 진심으로 환영합니다.
We're gonna start from Aaron Eagle. Ayo! Wait, I have a theory. What if Cher enters Squid Game when he's ordered to avenge Sebyeok and earn money for him and his mother if she's still alive? That's sweet, but my brother shouldn't go there to play. And still, like, he has money that Gi-hun gave. So I think, no. I'm gonna say no for that. 철이 집에 있어. It means that you gotta stay at home, safe. From Sky TV, there's several clues throughout the show that hint 001 is 456's father. I heard that a lot. It's hilarious. When 456 refused to drink regular milk, 001 says his son hated milk too. On October 24th, 001 says his son's birthday is coming soon. 456's birthday is October 31st. Oh, I didn't know that. During the Marvel game, 001 says he lived in a similar neighborhood. 456 says, so did he. Aha! The door of the house where 001 gets killed is the same as 456's mother's house. Oh, is that? Because the door is very kind of Korean house door. It looks like similar, but I kind of think that it could make sense, you know? But that's even more stressful to watch. Do you guys need more stress? I mean, I think I'm enough. Maybe the director Hwang needs more stress, but I'm a more peaceful person. Anyone else notice when number 67 died in Squid Game, her name was never called out through the speakers? Right? My theory is that she is still alive, and even though her neck was bleeding out, she somehow saved herself. I wish to. I mean, I never thought about that way because I was quite happy that I can die. If it's like, makes sense. So I can, you know, get rid of every stress from the Sebyeok's life and then in real life acting as a Ho-yeon. From Water Bucket G, the marble game. You need to get your opponent marbles. What if the players just traded marbles? Everyone wins. But you gotta need 20 marbles, right? It's like not about trade. Sorry, guys. Someone gonna die. From at With Me Downhill, Il-nam gave Gi-hun his jacket to maybe suggest him become the next player to possible frontman VIP in the future. I'm not sure because I'm going very serious discussion because I whole about the, you know, purpose of Gi-hun's character is that what director wanted to say to the world. So I think he couldn't be. Maybe there is other purpose in a good way that Gi-hun turns to frontman, then it makes sense. But otherwise, I'm not agree with this theory. Gi-hun is not going to be real frontman. I almost don't agree every theory, I think. Okay, let's move on. From Dean Cadence X, Sebyeok promised her brother that next year they will be together again, right? And at the end of the series, it was a year later. What if in season 2, she will come back? Okay, we know she died, but plot twist happened, right? And since she said she keeps her world, so what if? Yeah, I know. I should keep my words. Director and I was like joking about if there is twin sister or like that, but yeah, I don't think she might come back. No, I mean, and also, guys, I'm so sorry to say this, but I'm very happy to be dying. So yeah, from Western Indication 840. I recently saw some theories that Squid Games was located on Jeju Island. Isn't that where Ji-young says she wanted to go with Sebyeok when they get out together? When they are talking in the Marvel games, they imagine that future is going to be an idyllic place, but it's literally the same hell they are living in. If you guys ever been to Jeju Island, there is no place like to have this kind of big, huge game set. Jeju Island is one of the kind of big island in Korea, and then there is many people living there. They have their life. I don't think that they could have this like private place to make people do the game. You should go to Jejuland and check it out. How does it live there? So, but you're gonna know it. Okay, next one from Hunter 037. Sang-woo would have won if he didn't kill Sebyeok. Sebyeok wouldn't have died in the night from her injuries anyway. By killing her, Sang-woo angered Gi-hun enough to want to kill him. No, there is no way to Sang-woo win, I think. It must be Sebyeok or Gi-hun. But Park Hae-soo is one of the beautiful actors. I love him, but I hate Sang-woo. That's it. These two are very different. I just wanted to let you know, guys. From It's the DD Beaches 2. What if Ali and Kang Sebyeok didn't die? They were taking organs from other players' bodies. What if they took them to heal the wounded ones and make another game? That could be fun, but it's going to be a Squid Game zombie season. Like, because we are all injured and then we're gonna do like Marvel game like this, and then like green light, red light, this. I mean, you guys have so many good ideas for season two. The director Hwang should read this all to get some idea. From Bu, not prepared. Whatever color card was chosen at the beginning would determine your role in the game. Example, Gi-hun choose blue, so he was a player. The ones that choose red become a guards. I saw this theory, but director Hwang, I think he said that he only chose the color because Korean stories, when we are young, like we call it 동화. When you are at bathroom, there is a ghost inside of the toilet. So when the ghost hands came out and they offer you blue toilet paper and red toilet paper, and then he said that it's based on the stories of why he chose these two colors. We do have urban legend. Some of the color makes you fall into the toilet. Like the ghost grab you into the toilet. I know it's gross, but I can't actually remember what was the whole story was. Let's just Google. Yeah, guys, Google red toilet paper, blue toilet paper. Thank you for watching Fan Theories. See you soon for next season, maybe. Bye. We don't know. So bye. Oh, I'm dizzy.